have said that a sort of fascist culture is taking over. Politics are increasingly becoming authoritarian, intolerant. But one thing certainly one feels assured that Rohit Wemla incident is being debated all over India and even at a global level. As Professor Nacharya has said, in fact, in I think New York, in one of the international conference, they devoted the half day to Rohit Wemla incident. So it has definitely picked up, and there is a deep concern. And I was in Banaras, Arbat, you know, I was in that park, as a part of our Right to Education movement, and Rohit Wemla is being very seriously debated in Allahabad, in Banaras, in Lucknow. And one finds that there is a serious debate. You go to Gujarat, you know, you find that Rohit Wemla, I think it has now become not only an issue of universities, but it has become definitely a political issue. And in Maharashtra, 15,000 people have taken a position in Bombay city on Rohit Wemla issue. But very interestingly, the Telangana region, which fought, which is known for its struggles, and known for its Dalit movement, has not been able to mobilize the public as massively as several other states are able to. This what also is a bit surprising. Recently, when I met some of these Dalit movements, I was asking them, why in Maharashtra, if 15,000 people could be mobilized, why are we not able to have a major demonstration in Hyderabad, where you know, it can make a difference to the at least local state? But I think, therefore, I would personally think that this issue has to be still taken to the people, and a massive public opinion has to be built. This is absolutely important, because the Telangana state, the indifference of the state is also disturbing. One who watched the debate in the assembly, it was a very, I thought it was such a, interesting, such a provocative debate. It was very reassuring. Just member after member in the assembly spoke. And at the end of the debate, the way Chief Minister spoke, when the members insisted they should pass a resolution, he said, no, let's not pass a resolution. Give me 3 days and I'll see that the Vice Chancellor will be called. This was his assurance to the House. What happened? What is the opposition party doing? Why are they not raising the issue? Is it that just Chief Minister make an assurance? It has no meaning. I think this is one thing that perhaps bothers us. The second thing is about the university academic community, Hyderabad University academic community. Also feel upset, as Krishna was telling, that some of us, Vice Chancellor used to think we were also a little problematic. But definitely we had done a lot of firefighting operations. And there was a time when a faculty member was about to be touched. I was the president of the Teachers Association. I walked into the executive council meeting. I told my resignation. I said, I'm resigning from the university. If you take any action. Then the Vice Chancellor said, no, see, please wait. And the entire executive council with it. And they were days, but we have been able to, because there was also large number of teachers who were able to take stand. And but now the academic front, this entire science faculty, see the way they think. I mean, unfortunately, they are not taught anything very social, but they are very deeply involved. They are all good scientists, and they do very good work. They have an international reputation. But I have been, on even the first day when I went to Hyderabad University to speak on Rohit Wemla, my appeal was to the university community that if you do not protect the democratic space, you can't carry your scientific research. Scientific research has grown only in democratic climate. Scientists fought the state. Scientists fought the state. Scientists fought the religion. And today, whatever scientific freedom they enjoy, it is the contribution of the sacrifices of several people in the past, including Galileo, Copernicus, Bruno, all of them, suffered because to give the freedom. They think they have nothing to do with the whole thing. They want university to be very orderly, to be very disciplined. And I think it's the time that the university community realizes that it has to protect its democracy. We are science discipline, our social science. They think freedom is the concern of social scientists and not the science people. I think somewhere university community will have to educate Krishna. I would think that there is a necessity to protect the democratic space. This community has to be, very serious debate has to be carried within the campus, because I still find the attitudes are absolutely, you know, undemocratic. So, well, some of the young colleagues, you know, when I'm talking to them, they also feel that, no, I mean, you know, why students should do this, we should do, you know, we are here only for academic pursuit. What do you mean by academic pursuit? What is academic pursuit? And social transformation is a part of the function of university. Rohit Memla, they should shock everybody in university. And see, therefore, I would think that protecting democratic space in University of Hyderabad has to be done at two levels. One, fight within the university. Second, you know, mobilizing the public opinion outside. I think this has to be carried at two levels. The second thing is the withdrawal of the cases, for example. When the 11 Dalit boys were punished, we fought and fought. I was also in the executive council. And finally, when the council decided to withdraw all the cases against the 11 boys, Madhav Menon said that we can withdraw because he was a part of our governing council. He said, but what do we do in the criminal cases? Yes, even criminal cases, we negotiated with the police. And we saw that all the cases are dropped in the 11 students were free, but we had to fight. We had to call the commissioner. We called the commissioner to the university. We didn't go. Commissioner came with the entire police room, bureaucracy, and we had a 2 hour discussion. Then we explained to him, and then, you know, he said, please take an assurance, dropping cases may be difficult, but we ensure that the justice is done to the boys. I think the fight has to be carried on, and the university community should carry this fight, and the cases should be immediately dropped. I think that should be one of the major demands, that the cases against the boys should be dropped, all the criminal cases, and the two faculty members against whom the university has gone. I think there is a shameless move to hand over the teachers. I was asking the commissioner, what happened, police commissioner? How could you slap a teacher? He said, no sir, I don't know. I mean, these fellows are managing the BJP and, you know, the government is managing some other level. Some of these younger fellows, my buddies, you are a commissioner. He said, but no, I am not even know of things. He says that somewhere something is being managed. And I said, therefore, I think the cases have to be dropped. And the university gate, you know, that police should be removed. And only democratic space will help this fellow to govern. Even the vice chancellor, in the interest of the vice chancellor, with the cumulative anger, if you suppress, cumulative anger will take such a form, it will become ungovernable. University will become totally ungovernable. It is the democracy that protects the system. And vice chancellor do not understand that. They are very unfortunate. They do not understand that governance of the university cannot be done through hierarchy, through authoritarian model. It has to be done in a very democratic way. This vice chancellor believes that discipline is very important, because several times I had a confrontation. And several times he used to argue with me, you are promoting indiscipline. You are promoting, you know, anarchy on the campus. And he used to complain outside that these are the teachers who are promoting, you know, I mean, anarchy, indiscipline in the campus. And he became the vice chancellor. And his notion of discipline is completely different. But I think it's a time that you understand. But no one should demand that if the university democratic space is protected, as Jawaharlal Nehru said, if something goes wrong with the, you know, university, something has gone wrong with democracy. I think Rohit Memla comes as a sort of, you know, indicator of what is happening in the society. I think therefore we demand that the democratic space is restored, the cases are dropped. And SCST, because yesterday I was addressing a group of officers, there were 26 police fellows. And one of the police officers gets up and asks me, tell me the caste of his family. His family. I said, what do you mean by family caste? I am not asking Rohit Memla, I am asking what is the family caste. I said, how can there be family caste? He said, you know, then I asked him, now with the husband and wife, there were a large number of women officers also. I asked the women, whom do you consider? Now, mother is a Dalit and the father abandoned. The child was brought up by mother in a Dalit community. Now, this you are asking a question, what is the caste of the family? And there is something wrong. Something wrong. Therefore, the entire SCST atrocities act should be applied. SCST commission, as Anjay was mentioning, has already decided, and the collector has already submitted the report. And therefore, we are demanding that the SCST Act should be invoked, the people concerned should be booked, they should be punished. That's only the way that, you know, you can assure the nation that some justice still remains. the BJP government should realize that they can't, you know, have this cow in all these cultural issues, they won't help. Finally, this society has to be changed. And you talk of nationalism, patriotism, and all that, this is, has no meaning, it's hollow. If no justice is done to Rohit Vemula. I think this message that if justice is not done to Rohit Vemula, there is nothing like patriotism, nationalism, building superpower, it will become hollow. And that is the reason why we are taking Rohit Vemula as a test case, and the fight for the justice for Rostin Rohit Vemula is fighting against the fascism, against authoritarianism, against undemocratic values. This struggle has a larger implication for the nation, larger implication for politics of the nation and the future of democracy of this nation. And that's the reason why such a large number of friends, whether it's Sudhi or whether it's Rama, whether it's Chokarama, and all of us gather, because we're concerned. We're concerned with the democracy, we are concerned with the future of democracy. And University of Hyderabad students, young students, should also know that their future is linked with democracy. And if the university democratic space is stifled, I think there is something going very seriously wrong in this country. And in that spirit, I support all the three demands that, you know, the resolution, you know, mentioned. And I think this struggle has to be carried forward. As Krishna said, this struggle has to be carried forward. I think we appeal to a larger section of the society, particularly media. The media now is completely marginalized the issue. And, you know, they have mentioned somewhere in the, you know, district edition, some news, you know, even this meeting, you know, I was also reading up to some of the journalists, please give a good coverage, you know, cover it in the state edition, it's a very important issue for the, you know, media, you know, you want to personally address them. Don't they know that this is a very serious issue? Don't they know that this issue has a larger social and political implication? So I bet they are managing. The media also is being managed. And we have to also put a lot of pressure on the media so that there is a greater public information, there is a greater public education. So I think this meeting to me signifies a lot. It's a very important meeting at a very crucial time in the history of University of Hyderabad and also the transition of India at this stage, you know, in the history, you know. I stop here and, you know, I compliment the organizer for organizing this meeting. A message should go from this meeting to the Chief Minister of Telangana. A message should go to the central government. A message should go to the larger society that deeper human and democratic values are involved in the case of Rohit Vemula. It's not Rohit Vemula per se. It is Rohit Vemula symbolizing certain aspirations, certain transition of the society.
Thank you, sir.